Respiratory therapists serve as vital members of the healthcare team. This means that they play an important role in emergency cardiovascular life support. When providing emergency care, first and foremost, RTs are responsible for establishing and maintaining a patient's airway in order to facilitate ventilation and oxygenation. They also assist with pharmacological therapy, circulatory support, and patient monitoring, among many other duties. With that said, it's important to develop an understanding of the different types of emergency life support, which is what we are going to discuss in this video. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. First and foremost, let's talk about CPR, which stands for cardiopulmonary resuscitation. It's an emergency medical procedure for life support that involves repeated chest compressions and artificial ventilation in an effort to restore spontaneous breathing and blood circulation in a patient who is in cardiac or respiratory arrest. BLS stands for basic life support and is the most common type of CPR. The reason that it's considered to be basic is because it can be performed without equipment or medications to assist with the immediate survival of a patient who is in cardiac or pulmonary arrest. It involves delivering high-quality chest compressions and ventilations and the use of an AED if necessary. BLS courses and certifications are required for healthcare professionals and others who need to know how to perform cardiovascular life support skills. Then there is ACLS, which stands for Advanced Cardiac Life Support. It's an advanced form of life support for the treatment of cardiac arrest, stroke, myocardial infarction, and other life-threatening cardiovascular emergencies. It's a more advanced type of emergency care that extends BLS capabilities beyond immediate ventilatory and circulatory assistance. Some examples of the therapeutic measures that can be performed during ACLS include intubation and airway stabilization, mechanical ventilation, CPR, cardioversion, defibrillation, chest tube insertion, needle decompression, central venous catheter placement, breathing treatments, and oxygen therapy. Keep in mind that other therapeutic methods may be performed. These are just some of the most common examples. And last but not least, there is PALS, which stands for Pediatric Advanced Life Support. PALS is similar to ACLS, except it is designed specifically for the treatment of critically ill infants and children instead of adults. The PALS program was created by the American Heart Association and American Academy of Pediatrics with a goal of achieving the best possible outcome for a pediatric patient in emergency situations. Both ACLS and PALS typically require a group effort that is performed by a team of doctors, nurses, and respiratory therapists. Each provider is specially trained and should have the proper certification while working in a setting that may require emergency life support. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. And just a reminder, this video is for educational and informational purposes only. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.